Hello students, myself NS Yadav. Our channel is GB Physics Coaching Classes. Today we shall start a new chapter of class 12th, Magnetic and Magnetic Materials of Unit 3rd. Class 12th. Unit 3rd, Chapter 5th, Magnetism and Magnetic Materials. First of all, there are so many topics like bar magnet, lines of magnetic field, torque, dipole moment into it on the axial line and equator line, and there is a classification of the magnetic material like ferro, para and dia, and also the earth magnetism and the elements of the earth magnetism. These are the topics in which we shall study in details one by one. So first of all, we shall take bar magnet. Bar magnet is a small piece of rectangular magnet. It has south and north pole separated by a distance. The bar magnet is a piece of rectangular piece of magnet. Which has north and south poles separated by a distance. By a small distance. The strength of poles are equal. So it is also known as magnetic dipole. Magnet, this is north pole and this is south pole. The poles are inside and near to the end, not at the tip. The poles are inside, near to the end, inside a little distance, very small distance. Inside this place, near to the end. Such this pole, south pole is just near to the end, and north pole is just near to the end. Now properties. Properties of magnet. First of all, attractive property. The steel, iron, nickel, cobalt, such type of materials is brought to near to the poles, they are attractive. So the pole has the attractive nature. The main need about the bar main. Has the attractive property. When iron, steel, nickel and cobalt pieces are brought near to the poles, they are attractive. The strength of the pole is the strength of the magnet. More is the attractive property, attraction. Then more is the strength. The pole strength is the strength of the magnet. The strength of the magnet. So this is the attractive property of the magnet. The bar magnet has the attractive property when iron, steel, nickel, and cobalt. Pieces are brought near to the poles. They are attracted more. More is the attraction, then more is the strength of the pole. The pole strength is the strength of the main beam. Second property, directive property. When the freely suspend the bar magnet, it stays in the north-south direction. Suppose this is north and this is south, then the pole north, south, east and west. Then magnet will freely suspend it, it will stay in north and south. Then the bar magnet suspended freely stay in north and south direction. The line joining the poles is known as the magnetic axis of the bar magnet. The line joining the south and north pole is known as the magnetic axis. It is known as the magnetic axis. Magnetic axis of the bar magnet. And the plane perpendicular to the magnetic axis is the magnetic meridian. The plane perpendicular to the magnetic axis is known as magnetic meridian. Geographical magnetic meridian is known as magnetic wave. Now, third property. Poles exist in pairs.
North and South Pole, the bar magnet has north and south poles. It cannot have a monopole. Either north or south. If we break the bar magnet into pieces, like this, this is north and this is south. We break it into pieces, then it is north, it is south, it is north and it is south. It will break it like this. And we can write it this way. It means two pieces as separate poles. Property 4. Attractive and repulsive. Same poles repel each other. Like pole repel each other. And unlike poles. If North Pole is broad, near to South Pole, near to North Pole, it is repelled. the south pole we brought nearer to north pole than it attracts. Property 4. Magnetic induction. Magnetism by induction. When a piece of iron or magnetic material is of a magnetic material is brought near to the magnet, the magnetic property is induced by the material. The magnetism is reduced in the material. And there is also a property six. Repulsion is the surest test of the magnet. Repulsion is the surest test of the magnet. This is the north pole and this is south. If we brought any material near to any pole, then this is attracted. Because by induction, the magnetic property developed in the material. But another magnet is brought to south north pole. If there is the south pole, then it is attracted. If there is the north pole, that is the repulsive. So the material and the magnet can be rectified or can be known by the nature of the magnetism. If the material is always attractive, that is a magnetic material. But by one end it is attracted if we brought
near to the other end, then it is repulsive, then that is the magnet.
So we can explain it. When a magnetic material and a magnet is brought to the near to the magnet pole. If both are attracted, then both are attracted. If we change the polarity of the magnet, then magnetic material is attracted then magnetic material is attracted while the magnet is repelled. This way we can recognize the magnet this way our bar magnet and its properties completely we finish our lecture here. Okay.